Hi everyone and welcome back. My name is Sergiu Gabor and I'm a quality engineer in the automotive industry. In this episode, we'll test three different performance air filters to find out which is the best by measuring how much horsepower you gain compared to a normal air filter and by measuring their particle retention capacity. Let's get started. High performance air filters are widely used in motorsport and have a pretty simple job. Basically, they need to allow as much airflow as possible in the engine without too much restriction. If the airflow is restricted, engine power is decreased. In comparison, normal air filters are quite larger, mostly because with this, the priority is to clean the air as efficiently as possible between service intervals. High performance air filters usually look like this. Or like this. These are called direct intakes or cold air intakes, and with this the whole air intake assembly needs to be removed and replaced with this dedicated system. On the other hand, we have the OEM replacement filter, which doesn't require any modifications to your car. It can simply replace your original filter in the original airbox. This is a much simpler approach and less expensive than the first option, but depending on your car, it may not be the best choice. More about that in a few minutes. So, in this episode, we'll focus on OEM replacement filters, as most people would probably choose something like this for its simplicity. But with either one, it's important to mention that these filters do not require replacing. Just wash them, apply fresh oil if required, and you're set to go. Now let's take a look at what products are we testing. The first product is from BMC, an Italian company with over 40 years experience in this field. BMC intake systems are used a lot in motorsport events, from Formula 1 to the World Rally Championship and even in MotoGP. According to the manufacturer, BMC filters are made out of cotton, soaked in low viscosity oil and covered with a metal mesh. The next product comes from AEM, and this is made in the United States. The company was founded in 1987 and is very popular in the tuning world. To be honest, my first encounter with this brand was back in 2003 when I was playing Need for Speed Underground. Those were the times. According to the manufacturer, the filter is oil-free and can go up to 80,000 km before cleaning, which is a lot. Normal air filters have a service interval of approximately 15,000 to 30,000 km. The third product comes from K&N, which is probably the most well-known aftermarket performance brand. With more than 50 years of experience, K&N has been involved in most motorsport events and has expanded its portfolio to cover many other aftermarket replacement requirements. However, their most popular product is the high-flow filters that we'll test today. It's also oiled, washable, and has a cotton filter media similar to the BMC. Besides the three high-performance filters, we'll also throw in a normal Mahle filter, both new and used. This will give us a comparison based in the following tests. We'll first start by testing the particle retention capacity of these filters, and in order to do so, I've designed a box that can simulate filter usage and measure some key parameters at the same time. Inside the box, you can see a high-sensitivity particle detector and a device to measure airflow. The suction will be provided by a leaf blower, which has a maximum capacity of 13 cubic meters per minute, which is much more than we need. To calculate the estimated amount of air your engine consumes, we have to make a big assumption. We are going to assume that your engine achieves 100% volumetric efficiency at open throttle, meaning that the volume of each cylinder is perfectly filled with air, which is very difficult to achieve in reality. So, using my car, which has a 1.9-liter engine, we can calculate that it consumes approximately 2.85 cubic meters of air every minute at 3000 RPM. So, we'll adjust the leaf blower to that value. Regarding the particles, I'm going to use 10 grams of cement powder that will be distributed over the filter evenly. Let's first start without any filter to have a control measurement. This particle sensor can distinguish between 6 particle sizes, from 0.3 microns up to 10 microns. On this graph, you can see that the large particles, shown in red, are far less compared to the smaller ones, shown in dark blue. Of course, all particles are bad, but larger ones can cause bigger problems. Okay, so now let's try with a new Mahle filter to see the difference. The quantity of cement powder is exactly the same, as is the humidity, temperature, and suction power. Well, that's quite a difference. We can barely see any particles larger than 1 micron, and even the very fine particles are reduced by a lot. Now, let's test the old Malle filter, which has been used for about 18,000 kilometers. This has an even better particle retention capacity than the new filter, and this is expected. As air filters age, more and more of those tiny pores within the filter media get blocked, so other particles cannot escape. Therefore, the maximum performance of a filter is not when it's brand new, but rather around its half-life mark. The first high-performance filter in this test is the BMC. We can definitely see an increase in the number of particles compared with the normal air filter from Malle. Next is the AEM filter. This has a slightly better result than the BMC and a better airflow. And now for the KNN. Okay, so the airflow is similar to the AEM, but regarding particle retention, it's almost as bad as having no filter at all. So, it's clear that particle retention performance is not a priority with these filters. No wonder, I mean, look at them, they're just as transparent as a pair of Victoria's Secret panties. But we can see that air volume is the key distinctive factor between them, with the best result being shared between AEM and KNN, although AEM had better particle retention capacity. I also measured the differential pressure, but between these three high-performance filters, there's absolutely no difference. If we take a look at their internal structure, we can see that both BMC and KNN have the same basic design, both being made out of gauze, I believe it's called. You know, the fabric that's used in bandages, that's the one. So, both filters have 4 layers of this fabric sandwiched between 2 layers of metal mesh. Let me show you. So, this is your filter material. This scissor doesn't cut. Oh well, I'm not gonna use the scissors. 2 layers. 3 layers. 4 layers. There's your filter. There are, I don't know if you can see it on camera, but there are big holes in this filter. On the other hand, the AEM has a different approach. It has 2 layers, one made out of felt, I believe, and another fiber layer similar to paper. Both of these are sandwiched between 2 metal mesh layers, just like the previous products. You can see how much more dense the AEM filter is compared to the BMC and the KNN. Alright, well, people are not buying these filters for their particle retention capabilities. I mean, come on, we all know that. People are buying products like this to gain some extra horsepower. So, in order to find out how much horsepower my car will develop with each of these filters, I'm going to use a dyno. And my friends over AutoPerform were happy to help out. And I have to give them a big shout out for this support, but their know-how speaks for itself more than I can ever do it justice. AutoPerform is among the first companies that pioneered engine remapping in our country and has over 16 years of experience in this domain. Their work is present on countless high-performance cars as well as family cars, new and old, and everything in between. I've been a client since 2009 without any issues, and that's thanks to their experience in engine remapping. Engine tuning is complicated stuff, and maximum horsepower is not all that matters. However, power delivery is much more important, and by following their advice, it's guaranteed that your car will perform exactly how you expect it to in a safe manner. Very nice guys over there, and I cannot recommend them enough. By the time I finish this video, they've just installed an upgrade on their dyno, which can now also test all-wheel drive cars. I leave some links in the description where you can find them if you're interested in taking your car to the next level. Okay, so let's start by comparing the new Malle filter with the old one. As mentioned earlier, this filter was used for about 18,000 kilometers, so it's pretty dirty and should have the worst results. The dyno tests were done one after another to avoid any variables like changes in ambient temperature, humidity or engine temperature, and so on. But it's important to know that just like any other measuring equipment, dynos have an error margin, and this margin depends on the specific machine. In this case, the error is very small. Looking at the results, we have the new Mahle filter in red and the used one in blue. The top lines show the torque with the peak value recorded around 2450 RPM. Below this we have the lines representing horsepower. In this case, the maximum value was recorded around 3900 RPM. It's important to mention that for these dyno runs, we performed two tests for each product. Moreover, the DIN corrections have been deactivated to better reflect the exact conditions present in the dyno hall, and a 20% brake was applied. So, the difference between them is just 0.1 horsepower and 1 Nm. Basically, the same. But it seems like up to 2000 RPM, the new filter offers an advantage of approximately 50 Nm and 2 or 3 horsepower. But after this, both filters offer pretty much the same performance. But you may be wondering, how is it possible that a used filter can offer the same performance as a new filter? Well, I know as a fact that air filters are somewhat oversized, meaning that manufacturers in most cases will design the air filter or the air intake system to handle more than what your engine needs. Besides this, the air filter used on my car can also be fitted on other car models, some with even bigger engine displacements. Talk about recycling. Okay, so now it's time to see how the performance filters do. But before I show you the results, comment down below which one do you believe it's better. Pause the video and let me know. I'll wait. Alright, drum roll please. There's no difference. Well, that's quite a disappointment, I'm not gonna lie. I honestly believed that there would be at least a small increase in power. You may see that in this graph, the line followed the same path over the whole rev range. There's just a very small difference in the torque line right at the start, where the BMC and the KNN have a little less torque, but that can be considered a marginal error. To be clear, I'm not saying that high-performance air filters do not work. They certainly do, but not on all cars. And this is the perfect example. Normal cars, like mine, get enough air with the stock intake system, and by using high-performance filters, you're not really achieving anything besides wasting your money and reducing your engine life. But if other upgrades would have been installed, like a bigger turbo, things would have been different. My car has a turbo diesel engine, and the amount of air intake is precisely controlled by the engine management unit, also known as the ECU. And since the stock filter is not restricting this air intake, installing a more permissive air filter is not helping. However, a naturally aspirated gas engine would probably develop a few more horsepower when equipped with such a filter, and maybe in a future video I'll test this too. Regarding the direct intakes I mentioned earlier, well, these are suitable for highly tuned and modified engines, where the stock intake system becomes a restriction in itself. Hot air is less dense than cold air, that's why these direct intakes are mounted somewhere with constant fresh cold air from the outside. Installing them under the hood in the engine compartment is not recommended, as the air around the engine can get very hot. If I had to recommend one of these three filters, I would say that the AEM is the best in this comparison. Mostly because it has better particle retention capabilities than the BMC and the KNN, while the airflow is still just as high as the KNN. But if you're not sure if these filters really offer an advantage for your car, you can easily test this on a dyno. Just measure the horsepower with the stock filter and then without any filter. If you gain any extra horsepower without a filter, then it's pretty much a guarantee that you'll increase your horsepower with the performance filter. However, if you need some extra punch from your engine that you can actually feel, there's even a simpler solution. ECU remapping. Let's see the difference. In red we have the original ECU map, and in blue we have the remap done by AutoPerform. And we gain almost 30 extra horsepower and 117 Nm of torque, which is distributed perfectly for casual driving, exactly how I use my car 99% of the time. This increase in power and torque is really noticeable, and in my opinion is the easiest way to get more out of your engine. So there you have it, my analysis of high performance air filters. I hope that for some of you these results save you some money, and for those who really benefit from such filters, can choose a better product based on this episode. I'll also test normal air filters in the next episode to find out which is the best, so make sure you are subscribed. If you find this video useful, please consider liking it and sharing it. If you would like to support the channel, you can do so by becoming a Patreon member at the link in the description. Supporting the channel allows me to invest more in products to test and review. Also, Patreon members have always early access to all my videos and can win some of the products that I feature on the channel. Until next time, thank you very much for watching and I hope you have a great day. Bye bye!